What's up everybody, my name is Captain Puggy, welcome to a new video on Minecraft PlayStation 4 Edition. Now today, a new update just came out, it's the 1.91 update, it's the villager and pillager update. So as you can see around me, the village has now been updated. So there's a lot of new things here, I got my patch note in front of me, so I'm gonna read to you and show you everything that's new. As you can see, all the villages has been updated, and they're not gonna look all like this. They will be different from biomes to biomes, so I will show you some picture of other villager in other biome. So there you have it. As you can see too, come on little buddy, don't be scared. Villager has now new skin too, so they will have the skin of their biome and their profession. As you can see, this is a priest villager, so he will have the priest skin, and also he's still brown because he's in on the biome a plane. I know I talk very strange today, guys. I'm kind of tired. I didn't sleep from a couple of days now. I will get to there in a second. This is all the new blocks, but I want to show you everything that's new first. So I'm gonna read to you guys everything that's new. Update village, like you can see over here, this is all the new village. They will be bigger, they will be more beautiful. As you can see, this is the kind of new house that you will see in now villages, and I think this is pretty awesome. This house looks amazing for a village house, you know, except for the roof part. Of course, like I showed you, there is new villager. Where you go? There is new villager. So villager have now new clothing to indicate their level, profession, and biome. Now villager can now sleep in bed. So when you go in their house, there will be some bed, so the villager will now sleep in bed. I think I can show you if I go to nighttime. Villager will supposed to go home when it's nighttime, and when it's daytime, they will go to the workplace. Okay, so it doesn't work for now, but like I took. Oh, wait. Yeah, okay. Now this guy's going to home, and okay. Villagers are now sleeping in bed, so how amazing is that? I mean, yeah, it still looks very glitching, but it's pretty awesome, I think. I think that will add some new, how's it called? Realistic way of Minecraft. I mean, Minecraft sometimes looks realistic, but this, I think this is more of a roleplay term. I don't know how to explain this, but I feel like Minecraft is getting more realistic every update, and I think this is pretty amazing. So I will put daytime on now. Like I said, villager now visit their job site during the day and go home at night to go to sleep. So yeah, like I told you, this is pretty amazing. Also, the zombie villager has now biome specific and profession skin layer. So also, the zombie villager are changing. I think I will add some picture if I can find them, because it's gonna be hard for me to find a zombie villager right now. But there is some picture I will show you now. So zombie villager will have the biome property. So if it's a zombie villager from the savannah, it will add clothing from the savannah, and it will add clothing from his last job before he died. So if it's a zombie villager priest, it will have this outfit but with zombie skin. So I think this is pretty amazing. Another thing that's pretty cool is villager can now change job. So yeah, that's pretty amazing. Villager can now take on a new profession when you're a job site block. So example, if a villager get close to is there an example? I know there is a house here, there you go, with a stone cutter. No, not this one. This one, there you go. So yeah, this villager will, if it was a priest before, it will change to a stonecutter villager just because he approached this block right here. So I think this is pretty amazing. So if you're looking for a priest and you don't find it anywhere, that's because he changed his job. Alright, moving on to the block. Now I'm pretty excited to show you this, guys, because there's a lot of new blocks and this one's personally my favorite, but I'm gonna get to this right after. So the first block I want to show you is the cartography table. Damn, it's hard to say, I'm sorry. A cartography table is right over here, so it provides an easier way to copy and enlarge maps. Maps can be locked by using glass pane. So yeah, you can add a map right here, so that's pretty amazing. I think this is another way to make realistic about Minecraft, and I think this will be pretty loved for the player. I mean, I kind of love it for myself, and I think I can put it the map, there you go. So you can put the map right here, and you can put another one to enlarge the map itself, so this map will be bigger when you put it on the wall. So that's pretty amazing, I think. Moving on to the new block, this is the grindstone. The grindstone is pretty useful for tools and weapons. You use to repair them, and you can disenchant weapon with this little tool. So this is pretty amazing. Moving on to a new block, this is the barrel. This is a new stocking item, store item like a chest, but can still be opened with a block on top of it. So this is pretty amazing, and there's a lot of space in this little buddy. I didn't even notice. Look at this. There's a little animation when you... Wow, this is amazing. I didn't even notice that, but that's pretty good. Damn. Okay. Moving on to a new block. This is the smoker. So the smoker is a new cooking device. So it will cook food much faster than the furnace. I'm gonna show you real quickly, because that cooks food like... Wow, that's pretty fast. Ooh, I took a bowl. I don't want a bowl. I want coal. And I want a little piece of sheep. There you go. So look how fast it goes. This is pretty amazing, but this is only designed for food, so you cannot put any, iron core and gold core and everything. Yeah, this is only for food, but you can do it with the blast furnace. Blast furnace is right here, so this is for smelting iron coal and golden coal. Hey, hello there, little sheep. And will go way much faster. So if you're asking, the furnace is still there, but this is way more faster, but it will cost more to craft. New block here, this is the composter. So like it says in the name, is for compost. If you add enough crops in it, it will produce bone meal, so you can do like bone meals farm. How to do cross, you just take a little food, like the new berry that just came out. I wanted to show you over there. This is the look of the berry that will be in the wild. So if you walk in the forest and you see this, this is a little berry tree, and you just right click on it and you will get some berry. And if you had some berry in there, like you see, it will grow and grow and grow and grow and grow and grow. And if you add enough, it will do bone meal. So this is pretty amazing. Now the stone cutter, I already talked about this one. So the stone cutter is pretty simple. It just cut every block that is in stone. I didn't know that block was made out of stone, but you can only use stone block in it, so there will not be wood block and other stuff. This is only stone one, and I think it looks pretty amazing. Like the little saw here adds a new animation in the game. This is really amazing, and it won't hurt you if you go on top of it. Unfortunately, that will be amazing, but I mean, this kind of look really good. Two new blocks that for now doesn't do anything. This is a smithing table and the fletching table. Functionality will come out in a later update. For now, they just block for the look, you know. And I don't really know what they do because I don't play PC. I'm pretty sure, as you can see, this one is to create arrow, and this one will be for creating tools, I think, I hope. And I just noticed that the berry bush slow you down like a cobweb. So yeah, that's a nice little secret. A new block, this is the bell. So the bell is used to by the new villager to tell them there is pillager coming out to attack them. So this is pretty amazing. So you will see this later little structure in like you see, I ran the clock, not the clock, the bell, and the villager just ran out in their home. So this is a little device to warn them that they will be, look at this, he just ran out home. This is a nice little device to provide them from being killed by a pillager. And last block, nonetheless, this is fire camp. Now the fire camp is a nice looking block, plus it cook your food. It will take a while to cook your food, but if you want to make survival, I said role play, let's play, stuff like that. Oh, you cannot put, oh, it wasn't, okay. You can put any kind of food, and you can put 4 food at once. And it will do like little smoky thing, so smoke signal, there you go, I was looking for the word. And smoke signal, you can see from it from pretty far actually. Yeah, from here this would be the max, you can see the smoke. No, you can still see it pretty far though. It's like a little smoke signal when you play with other friends and you don't find them because you lost. Little smoke signal, and like I said, this will take a while to cook your food, but I think this is pretty good and had more realistic to the game. I really like this, and this is one of my favorite new block, and I will use it for maps and survival stuff. Alright, now this is the boring part, guys, but this is all the new thing about villagers, so trading and stuff like this, so this will take a while. So if you're just looking for the block, just skip this to the end, and for now, this will be boring. Alright, so villager training changed too. Like you can see, the trade has been pretty much updated, so you can see the level of... Well, as you can see, this villager just changed profession just in front of our eyes, so this is pretty good. So now he's an arrow builder. So yeah, that's a thing that I really wanted to show you, but I didn't know how to quite do it. Yeah, so the villager had brand new trade, so I think it's going... I got the number here. 169,044 new object to trade. So this is a lot of new object. I mean, wow. Okay, so this one cannot trade. This is a regular villager. He doesn't do anything. But look at this guy. You can see the level. And there's a little canna on top of it just to show you that you cannot buy this yet. So you need to upgrade your villager first. And I think this is pretty pretty good, I think. Alright, just like in the whole day, when villagers make trade, they gain experience. When they gain enough experience, they level up. Leveling up unlock new trades. So yeah, just like in the old days, they will level up. But now they actually have levels. I can't find a villager that make actual trade. Wait, where are my villager? Oh, there you go. So like you see on top of his name, it's a level 1. So yeah, your villager can now gain levels, so they will be more, not stronger, but I mean, they will have better trades, they will have better deals too, because for now the deals are pretty cheap, but when you level up for at least 5 level, they will have really good trade. The only way to resupply a villager is for this villager to go on his job site. So if he's an arrow builder, he's gonna have to go on his job site, that is a house for only building arrows. I don't know where is the arrow building house, because the block for building arrows not been had. Well, it's had, but it's not used yet. But yeah, the only way to refile villager is to go on their job site. Alright, now talking about the pillager. So they had the new thing that called pillager outpost. Like I said, I didn't find any pillager outpost, so I would just add a little picture of it. So this is a villager outpost. It looks amazing and I cannot wait to find one in survival and fight those pillager. The only place that you can find those output is in the same biome that has already a village in it. So in this biome, there's supposed to be a pillager outpost. There is no like 100% chance that you will find one, but I say like 65% chance it will spawn an outpost pretty close to the village. And if it's not there, it's just because it didn't spawn, so you need to fight another village. When you clear out some pillager outposts, you get some pretty good loot. There is some chests in the outposts you can get when you kill them. And there is a boss actually in the outpost. It's called the Illager Captain. And he's stronger than the other pillagers, so you need to be careful about this guy. The Illager Captain can be found holding a banner in the pillager outpost. So if you found this one, well, if you don't know who's the Illager Captain, you just found a pillager with a banner in his hand, and this will be the boss that you need to take out to get the outpost. When a player killed the Illager Captain, the player that killed the captain will be given the Bad Omen effect. And what does the Bad Omen effect is when a player enters a village with bad omens, a raid will be triggered. So you will see a raid of pillager running into the village and start killing all those poor villagers. And I don't think they had a potion for that, unfortunately. If you don't know what a pillager raid is, this is a the pillager will start waves and attack the poor villager by killing them, of course, and destroying our culture. And I don't think they kill animals in the village, but I know they kill a villager. But you can still defend this wonderful villager. So if a player that successfully defend a village from a raid will receive the hero of the village effect, giving a step discount on trade with villager. So this is amazing. If you see like pillagers starting to kill villager and you stop the raids, villager will grant you with an award that's called the hero of the village effect. And it's like a potion effect, and every trade of the villager will have a good discount on it. So yeah, this will be your moment to start trading. I didn't talk about this new mob called the Ravager. The Ravager looks pretty dumb to me. I mean, look at his face. Like I said, I couldn't find one, so this will be in the picture. What does the Ravager do? This is a powerful new enemy mob found in the Illager Patrol and during a village raid. When running, it can destroy some blocks like crops, so watch out. It can be ridden into battle by Illager. You can see Pillager Patrol. What is the Pillager Patrol? This is a group of Illager, Pillager and Ravager that can be found patrolling in the overworld. So they won't only be attacking village. They will just roam around the world and start killing any player who get nearby or any villager that get nearby. Alright, new feature. Now, I already told some of it. There's the new campfire, the sweet berry, the bamboo jungle. This is pretty interesting. The bamboo is now generated in jungle and more decently in the new bamboo jungle biome. So there's the jungle biome and there is a bamboo jungle. Alright guys, so I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe if you already didn't. Drop a comment. If you have any question about this update, I will Of course, respond any comment I always do. If you, like I said, if you have any question, don't forget to ask me anything. I will tell you if I found anything new in this update. I will let you know, of course. So, alright guys, thank you for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.